Hi, I'm Wami Aluko, conceptual fashion photographer and stylist and founder of Waku.com. Well, I consider myself a very creative person. Like, since I was young, I used to sing, I used to draw, I used to be part of musicals, I used to dance, I used to do ballet, and I was like in ballet competitions and stuff like that. So all the creative arts I love. I used to play the guitar, I spent a lot of time making covers and stuff with my friends. I actually recorded like a 4-song EP, and I made a video with my friend Eniafe for one of the songs. I also did fashion shows, and I had one clothing line for a charity show in Grange. I was always in my camera taking pictures of people, and like I had a website called Glad It Became where I put all the pictures on. But I never really considered myself as a photographer at the time. I just did it for fun because I enjoyed taking pictures and documenting moments. During it was I studied art. I did art textiles, so I used to make clothes. I learned how to make clothes. I did a bit of that and like textile art. They asked me to take pictures of the subjects that I was painting or drawing or whatever. So that's kind of when I rekindled my love of taking pictures. During that time, obviously, I was still interested in fashion and style and all of that. And my friends always prompted me to start like a fashion website. Wura and Taylor specifically, they kept telling me that, well, we need to start this, like we need to start a fashion website. And I was quite nervous about it. I wanted to, but like, obviously I was nervous about putting myself out there because I was quite a reserved person. But then at the end of the day, I decided that, why not? So I started that. And firstly, it was actually, funny enough, it was meant to be a blog about me, about my personal style, but taking pictures of me and posting it. Until the day I decided that I wanted to style other people, because I didn't have access to photographers, and obviously because of art, and I started liking photography again, I was like, okay, let me take that myself. It was a great experience, and it opened my eye to the world of like fashion photography and all that, and I realized that I really love that. Like, I realized that that's what I really want to do as well. So that's kind of where it started, and gradually as the blog progressed, I started taking less pictures of myself and just focused on taking pictures of other people. I feel the fact that I grew up having diverse interests came together well when I started doing my photography, as it helped me come up with concepts and things like that. Like, everything just came together perfectly. The whole process was very fun, like experimenting with methods and the lighting and all that, and just like learning. It was a very big learning curve for me, like at the start. For example, all of my shoots, The Wonder Years, was inspired by John Boyer and his song The Wonder Years. So also my interest in like graphic design came in as I reached out to graphic designers, and I love the idea of mixed media, mixing photography with other mediums of art. I play with colors a lot. I'm very like particular about color schemes because I'm a very visual person. The concepts are important. Clothing is also very important to me. So like I said, I was interested in fashion. I feel like fashion and clothing says a lot. Like in my documentary, Neogenesis, it was basically like an introduction to more of the film that have to come. It's basically about how clothing has stories behind it. Like every item of clothing has a story behind its creation, where it was made, and has like some sort of significance, like looking at cultures and stuff like that. So in my shoots, naturally, like that's important to me, and I'm very careful about the clothes that I wear and where I get my clothes from. One shoot that I can say that probably represents what I'm all about is my shoot called, I did recently, called Sorry I'm Late. That shoot, I feel, is very representative of who I am. The colors, the styling, and everything. You see that the, like my heritage in it, the hair, the bantu knots. I love doing street photography, shooting people in their day-to-day lives, and like focusing on things that people may overlook, and just showing the beauty. Like, there's beauty in capturing moments. Another one of my favorite shoots I've done are the two shoots actually that I did with Winnie Madueke, one called Terra and the other one was Safara. Safara is basically a character that I created. I like creating personas in my photography. And then Terra, which was about the earth, she was wearing this cowrie bead choker and head wrap. It was very simple, but I feel like the pictures themselves said a lot. Going back to my love for music, I actually started this documentary called For Those Who Listen. The title was actually interesting because I was watching a documentary on John Bellion, and he was talking about like why he makes music, and he was like, he makes music for people who listen, people who appreciate music and feel music, and not just like, doesn't just go past them. And that really like inspired me because I think I'm a person that really like listens to music. Like, I love music. I pay attention to the instruments and everything that comes into creating a song. The documentary is basically about the impact and the power of music amongst Nigerian youth and seeing how everything has kind of trickled down from the creators, the people who make the music, to the people that put music together, the big playlists, and like DJs, and then people who just listen to music and just have a passion for music, and seeing how kind of that the music and how everything trickles down and how people inspire and also make other art, which also inspires artists to make more art, and the whole like process. I just want to like also bring to light like a lot of the good music that people are doing right now and like all the other people, all the artists I've worked with so far. Reduce the Engine, The Just King, Lady Gunny, You Say Easy. That was like an amazing experience because I was following him on tour and I interviewed him there and shot his at his concert, which was a great experience. So it's exciting. I don't know if the album just come out, that comes out in December. But currently I'm posting shoots that I've done with those artists on my website and a new tab called For Those Who Listen, basically like introducing you to the artists that I'm going to feature. My most recent shoot is called A Day With Miss Crowd in Yoruba. That shoot is very Nigerian inspired. It was actually inspired by music, specifically Fela Kuti. I was looking into a lot of his concerts, the way he performs. I was inspired by his backup dancers then, and the way they dress. As I was looking into his life, I learned a bit more about his mom, Fela Kuti. I like the fact that she was such a big empowering figure. So I wanted to take elements of her and like the fire and incorporate it into the way the backup dancers were and like show how women are allowed to be free and just like move and dance and be angry, which also led me to use a lot of red in my shoot because red symbolizes fire, symbolizes passion, so many things. There was this really cool picture of Fumayo with sunglasses and he gave it on and I thought that was so cool. So yeah, that kind of inspired me as well. Fela Kuti's backup dancers has amazing eye makeup and like face paint and all that stuff. I made sure the eye makeup was very interesting. Like one had this red line, it's like oily, greasy eye makeup, but like this yellow like geometric line on their eyes. So I thought that was really cool. I'm really excited to see what the future holds. I'm definitely gonna do more editorial work, do more collaborations with different artists, and do more fashion film for sure. And yeah, I'm excited to see how like my creativity like progresses and how my style of photography is going to change, or the more things I'm going to do. I'm not perfect, but I'm happy with where I am now, and I'm excited to see where I'm going to go.